Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Paul Chiam, an interventional cardiologist utilizing state-of-the-art techniques to enable minimally invasive treatment of heart conditions. Today, we shall dive into the specifics of a critical heart condition called aortic valve stenosis and its minimally invasive treatment known as TAVI, or transcatheter aortic valve implantation.
I'm Michael Seat, I'm 76. I've had a few problems with my heart and I decided to go for a checkup. From the ECG test, they discovered that I had a certain blockage of the heart. They wanted me to do more extensive tests, which eventually led to the idea that I had to go and do surgery to replace my blocked heart valves.
Aortic stenosis is a serious condition in which the aortic valve, the gateway that allows blood flow from the heart out to the aorta and then to the rest of the body, becomes narrow and rigid. This restricts blood circulation, forcing the heart to work harder. Unfortunately, its symptoms are often mistaken for typical signs of aging, which can lead to delays in diagnosis and treatment. These symptoms can include fatigue, shortness of breath, chest pain, fainting, and irregular heartbeats. Aortic stenosis is quite common, affecting approximately 1 in 8 people aged 75 and above. If left untreated, severe aortic stenosis can lead to serious complications such as heart failure and death. Therefore, it is crucial to seek treatment as soon as symptoms become noticeable.
I had noticed that I had lost weight progressively, which prompted me to go for a full checkup as such.
There are various treatment options, from medications that can manage symptoms but cannot reverse the condition, to surgery. The traditional surgical method involves open heart surgery to replace the faulty valve, a major operation that requires significant recovery time.
After consultation with the cardiologist, he recommended that the surgery was the best way to take care of the clogged valve and explain the procedure to me, which didn't exactly got me excited, because open heart surgery is a much more complex procedure.
Over the past two decades, a minimally invasive procedure known as TAVI has emerged and evolved, providing a viable alternative to traditional open heart surgery. Unlike open heart surgery, TAVI does not require splitting the chest bone. Instead, a catheter, which is a tube, is inserted through a small incision in the leg, guiding a replacement valve to the diseased aortic valve. Once positioned correctly, the new valve replaces the faulty one, allowing the heart to pump blood more efficiently. Most TAVI procedures are performed under sedation or even with just local anesthesia, and patients typically report immediate symptom improvement.
I began to ask other friends and who are also doctors for advice. Strangely enough, my lawyer told me that his niece was a cardiologist in America, and he would then consult her and see what she suggests, because you know, I wasn't in favor of open heart surgery. She came back and said, "Aren't you aware there's something called a TAVI procedure, which is the least invasive of all procedures?" And you know, explain roughly how it was done. Having that option made me choose it almost immediately.
The patient chose the TAVI procedure, a decision that resulted in significant improvements to his health and quality of life.
Dr. Chiam explained to me how he was going to carry out the procedure, and my main concern was how long it was going to take. He said it was relatively fast once all the procedures have been done. I think it took less than 1 hour because I didn't take the option of being given anesthetic to sleep. He said I could watch it on the TV screen if I wanted to. He was also explaining what he was doing and so forth.
Recovery from a TAVI procedure is quicker than traditional open heart surgery. Indeed, the patient was discharged just 2 days after the procedure.
After the procedure, I was moved to the ICU where they monitor all your vital signs, and I was then released to the room the next day, and I stayed there until the third day when I checked out.
Upon discharge, our team provided him with tailored guidelines for his home recovery, which included wound care, activity advice, potential signs of complications to monitor, and a follow-up visit schedule. Adopting a heart-healthy lifestyle after the procedure is essential. This includes maintaining a balanced diet, regular exercise as recommended by your healthcare provider, and if necessary, smoking cessation. Following these post-operative care and lifestyle adjustments, patients like Mr. Seed can expect significant symptom improvement and a better quality of life. Keep in mind that individual recovery paths vary, and following your medical team's guidance is paramount.
The most significant thing was the weight off my mind. You know, avoiding the ordeal of having to go for full surgery. The TAVI has made a big difference. And I've been recommending it to quite a few friends who have similar problems though.
For those of you who may have aortic stenosis, please do not overlook or downplay your symptoms. Speaking to a healthcare provider and understanding your treatment options is important. Despite the severity of aortic stenosis, timely diagnosis and appropriate treatment can prolong survival and enable you to lead a healthy and active lifestyle.
I'm still doing all the things I used to do, maybe not so physical in view of my age.
Finally, thank you for your time, and please do not hesitate to reach out to a healthcare provider like myself if you have any concerns or questions about aortic stenosis or the TAVI procedure.